Good evening, children. The story I am going to narrate today is Drawing Test. Joe was a very unhappy child. There was a drawing test in his school the next day and he did not want to be there. The children always made fun of his drawings, no matter what. Little Joe knew well that whatever he made in his test, the hut, the tree, the kite or the flower, he would be shamed and laughed at. His drawing was really very funny. And Joe cried in anguish. I don't want to learn read and write. I'm so happy in my home. When Joe was small, he always dreamt of going to school. And he loved spending all his time in drawing. He loved making houses, trees, birds, but his trees, birds and the huts were always hideous, crooked and hunchbacked. Not a single line he drew was straight up and down. And unfortunately, when little boy was given a box of crayons to color, his color scheme was equally poor. He would fill his huts and birds with unusual colors. And his all houses would be blue, chimneys yellow, trees red, and the birds green. And the smoke that came out of the chimney of his houses would always be pink. These drawings were pretty pictures for him. But anyone who came to little Joe's house would always ask, "Where did you ever see the red trees and the green birds?" In this picture, Joe would reply innocently. No one appreciated his drawings in his home, but no one chid it too. And lo, his loving mother encouraged him to make more and more houses with more and more trees. But in the school, things were different. Joe drew so poorly that when the boy saw his drawings, a ripple of laughter would run right through them. Miss Lena, his drawing teacher's face, would become all puckered in a frown as if she had eaten a sour lemon. And little Joe would feel very hurt and sore himself then. Some of the kind girls felt sorry for him, and when the teacher turned her back, they would quickly draw something in his drawing book. They tried to do their worst, but no one could draw as badly as Joe. The teacher would notice the difference immediately, and Joe was honest enough to accept that it was not his work. The teacher would then say, "Joe, you have to do it yourself." It was a serious matter, and Dad had to help. He called Joe and said, "It's all right, Joe. You'll be the only child in the class drawing with a bangle." Dad took one bangle and drew a circle with its help. Then he took another round cap. With that, he made another smaller circle on top of the first one. He made a letter M on top of small circle and a zigzag tail on a big circle. And when he drew two small eyes and few straight lines as mustache in the small circle, lo and behold, there was a cute little cat in Joe's book staring lovingly at him. "Wow, this is easy, Dad. I think I can make it. But what color shall I use to fill it?" Joe shouted in happiness. "Use the colors that you have seen in a real cat," Dad advised him gently. The next day, everyone, including Miss Lena, clapped for the beautiful kitten in the black and gray colors that Joe had made in his drawing test. It was not the best, but good enough to not to be laughed about. Thank you, children. Good evening, good night, and sweet dreams.